times when you're doing calculations, you need to base your numbers on a certain criteria. For example, the amount you pay your employees might depend on how well they've performed. In this video, you'll learn how to use lookup functions in Excel to fine-tune your calculations.
Here I have a marketing budget that I've started to fill out. Some of these numbers I've added manually, but some of them are calculated using formulas. To get a good overview of all the formulas in a spreadsheet, you can go to the Formulas tab, and in the Formula Auditing section, click Show Formulas. Now all the formulas in the spreadsheet become visible. You can also access this by pressing the keyboard shortcut Control Accent Grab, or Control Tilde if you have a US keyboard. To go back to the normal view again, I'll click Show Formulas.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
Another way to get a good overview of the formulas in your spreadsheet is by highlighting those cells. You can do that by going to the Home tab, and in the Editing section, click Find and Select, and then in the drop-down, select Formulas. All the cells with formulas will be selected. If you want to have better visibility of these cells, you can highlight them using a different cell background color. I'll click Undo here to go back to the original cell color. Now I'm going to continue filling out this budget. So I'll go to the first empty line item, which is direct marketing. Here, I want to allocate a fixed monthly amount of $250. But the months where we're investing a lot of money on events, $10,000 or more, I want us to double that amount and make it $500. Instead of manually tracking which months have $10,000 or more budgeted for events, I'm going to use a lookup formula, which will do this for me. I'll start by entering an equal sign to start the formula. Then I'll write if, left parenthesis, and here I can see that Excel helps me with the formula. First, I have to enter the so-called logical test. So I'll say, if the budgeted cost for the event that I have for January in cell C14 is larger or equal to 10,000 and then a comma, then the direct marketing budget should be 500. So I'll type 500 and then a comma again. Otherwise, it should be 250. I'll complete the formula with a right parenthesis. There. Now let's copy this formula to all the cells to see if we get the right result. That looks right. The months where we have the events that cost $10,000 or more, we spend $500 in marketing. Otherwise, we spend $250. For email marketing, we have a fixed monthly fee of $200. But the months where we have events that cost $10,000 or more, I want to add an additional 1% of the event cost to the $200. So to do that, I need to add some more calculations to my if statement. I'll start with an equal sign, type if again, and left parenthesis. For the logical test, I'll first mark the cell containing the events cost for January, C14. If this is larger or equal to $10,000, comma. If this is true, I'll add $200 plus 1% times the event cost, comma. Otherwise, I'll just add $200. I'll end with the right parenthesis and then enter. Now, I'll copy this formula again across all the months. You can see that I now have more money allocated for email marketing each quarter when I have my large events. If you use a value over and over again, or if you want to test different scenarios by changing values, or if you just want to make your formulas easier to read, you can give yourselves a name. Let's change the email marketing formula and make use of named cells instead. First, I'll type email marketing monthly fixed and enter the $200, which is the fixed cost every month in the cell to the right. Then, I'll write email marketing event increase and enter the 1%. Instead of referring to these cells as C23 and C24, I'll name them. There are multiple ways in which you can name your cells. You can mark the cell and type in a name in the text box up here. I'll click Escape here to show you another way. If you go to the Formulas tab and click Define Name, you can enter the name here in this text box. Excel has automatically taken the text to the left of the cell and added it as a name with underscore signs instead of spaces. You can keep this name or change it here in the text box. I'll click Cancel and show you the third way. Mark your cells, the ones with the names and the ones with the values, and click Create from Selection. Here, you need to tell Excel which cells you want to use for the name, and in our case, it's the cells to the left. And then Excel creates the names for me. If you click Name Manager, you can see all the names you have in your spreadsheet. And here you can add new names or change and delete existing names in your spreadsheet. So let's go back to our formula again and use these cell names instead of numbers. As I start typing the name, you will see all the matching names appear in the drop-down box. Here, I want to select the fixed fee, which is the bottom one, so I'll press arrow down on my keyboard and then press tab to select the highlighted option. Then I'll add the percentage increase multiplied with the amount budgeted for the event. I'll add a comma and then enter the name for the fixed fee. I'll end with the right parenthesis and press enter. Now I'll copy this updated formula across all months. Now I can easily try different scenarios. Say for instance that I want to increase the fixed amount to $250 and the percentage increase to 3%. I can see the results in my budget right away. Next, I want to budget for our PR. Our PR agency charges different fees depending on their media outreach performance. If their performance is 5, the cost is $5,000 a month. If it's 4, it's 3,000, and so on. For budgeting purposes, I'll just assume that they'll have the same performance this year as last. Now I need a formula that can check the performance number for the month, look it up in this table, and give the value in this column. I'll go to my budget and enter the formula, equal sign, and then I'll start typing VLOOKUP and select it in the drop-down list by pressing tab on the keyboard. First is the lookup value. This is the value I want to look up in the table. So I'll go back to my PR sheet and mark the first cell for January. Then I'll press comma to enter the table array. Here, I need to mark the columns in my lookup table with values. I won't include the headers. Here, I'll press F4 to make the table absolute, meaning that if I copy the formula, it should always refer back to these exact cells for the lookup table. I'll press comma again to get the next value, which is column index number. This is the number of the column of your lookup table that has the value that should be returned, and in our case, it's the second column that contains these values. Finally, I'll press comma again, and here I can select true or false. False means that the numbers are exact, meaning that there's no performance of 4.5. Okay, let's try this. The first result is 5,000, which is correct. Now I'll just copy the formula across all months. There, it worked. Now we're done fine-tuning our budget.